So, you know how to deal with a 5-year old, right?
I know how to deal with a 5-year old. Or you want to say, hi to Nick? He's not, the spotlight's not for
him. All right, that's all right. He's being very good tonight.
Thank you very much.
Our next performance tonight is going to be explained by Ishmael, representing the Buffalo Academy of Visual Performing Arts High School. Ishmael, come on out. I like the jog, I like the energy. I didn't know we were allowed to be barefoot. I should have. Tell me about what we're going to see tonight.
Tonight is the Circle of Bullying shown through movement, so we'll be dancing. And we have two continuous instances of bullying, which will cause turmoil. But we found that with the right support group, you can break that cycle and go on the path that you were meant to be.
The right path.
Yeah. All right.
Let's do it. Ishmael, get on back there. Get set for another great performance tonight. And once again, please welcome the Buffalo Academy of Visual and Performing Arts High School.
Thank you.
because I'm not too different from mom. So why is that not enough? I need answers. I know you don't care, but I do. Tell me.
Thank you.
I'm inspired, I'm invigorated, I'm a little hypnotized by the music tonight. That was good. Let's find out what our judges thought here tonight. Mr. Grant Michaels' thoughts.
You guys, that was unbelievable, man. The dueling guitars, that was amazing. Like, the way it just arced the performance and crescendoed up, and there were so many great elements. And the spoken word, that was so passionate and wonderful, and like, your voice is an instrument, and choose love, all, it was so good. Like, great job, you guys.
Can I just ask something?
Andrew,
I know you're not going to come to me, but I want to make sure. I want to ask you something, because you said about the guitar. What did you say, crescendo?
Crescendo.
I have no idea what that is. But I want to just say this. For those of you, like, the old farts like me, you might... I kind of got a little Dire Straits. The end of a Dire Straits song, or even, like, I was thinking, like, a Yellow Ledbetter by... I'm sitting there listening, and the whole time the music is just making me want to follow the story more. And like I said, I don't know anything about music, but I just thought the guitars were awesome. You guys were, I had to jump in, so selfishly on my part, you know, I'm a judge, so I feel like, hey, I can do that, so whatever.
You know, for a guy who says he doesn't know much about music, he pulled out the Dire Straits, which was bang on. Like, you know what you're talking about, Andrew.
Oh, yeah, well, listen.
That's not the hockey stuff. Do a music show.
Well, you know what? Like, listen, I love music. I grew up at a cottage, so we always had music going. My dad loves Dire Straits, so I mean, Dire Straits was on all the time. And I mean, that's why I just sit there going, like, this just sounds like a little Dire Straits.
So anyway, that was with Stevie Ray Vaughan, actually, right? And Stevie Ray?
Well, hey, I mean, I was born in 1980, so I don't know.
You went back to 67, man. I don't know who Jimi Hendrix was, but...
Literally giggling right here that he's getting compared to a Stevie Ray. A little Riviera vibe there was very nice. Bob, we'll go to you because I know you're a guitarist and I know you the whole time. This guy's just looking at the guitarist going, I can do that.
No, I'm sitting here saying, why couldn't I play that when I was his age? I'm saying, why can't I play
high schoolers?
Yeah, exactly. And no, I mean, I heard the music was phenomenal. I mean, the thing about this was, it was urban, it was raw, living in the city of Buffalo. I mean, everything you guys are playing up there, you know, the movements, the spoken word. I mean, that is the city, that is an urban vibe. That is a feel that if you live in it, you know it, and you get it. And I think bullying takes on so many forms. It happens in so many different languages and so many different ways that, you know, when you hear it expressed through spoken word and music and everything, you know, your message hits very deep. And it's not, you know, like I said, when I talk about a song sounding like it was on Broadway, or I talk about something, this sounds like it's straight out of the streets of Chicago. It's down, it's dirty, it's the real deal. And it was amazing. You guys did a really nice job with the visuals and everything. It was excellent. Very good performance.
Thank you, Robert. Amanda Anderson. Thoughts? Thank you.